Hello everyone, today we'll be showing you how to connect your motorcycle with the Kawasaki Rideology app and all the parameters and functionalities. We'll go through one by one by starting with connecting your motorcycle to your Rideology app through your smartphone. In order to connect your motorcycle with the Kawasaki Rideology app, you need to download the app from Apple or Google Play Store. Once you download the app on your smartphone, you can click the app to go into the menus. So over here, you'll see the location, and at the bottom, you'll see vehicle info. You'll see riding log, you'll see tuning, and you'll see settings. So once you connect, you need to go to vehicle pairing. The available motorcycle will be displayed on the display. As you can see over here, it shows Ninja 650. You need to turn on Bluetooth from your motorcycle settings. Go to Bluetooth, select. Once you turn on, you need to start selecting and pairing the motorcycle. So over here, you will get a passkey. You need to invert the passkey and pair. So your pairing is complete. You see the map over here. You have three buttons. When you click on the first one, it shows both the bike and your location. Next, it shows the location with the navigation setting where you can open the location of your motorcycle in Google Maps. So over here at the top, you will see the location of the motorcycle and your location. When you click on vehicle info, you'll see all the parameters of the vehicle displayed over here, like odometer, trip A, trip B, total engine running time, your range, fuel level, average mileage, fuel consumption, average speed, max lean angle, battery voltage, etc. Now moving on to the second functionality, it is called the riding log. This is very useful to track your ride when you're riding your motorcycle from a particular destination. In order to start the riding log, you need to click on the plus sign given at the top right corner. And once you start play, once you press the play button, it starts recording your log. Going to the third functionality, tuning. So over here, you have Kawasaki Riding Management at the top and General. Now coming to Kawasaki Riding Management, currently we are connected to Ninja 650. And it does not support riding modes or traction control, hence nothing is displayed over here. So now we'll connect to a Ninja 1000 SX and show you how we can set the Kawasaki riding management. So now we are connected with the Ninja 1000 and we will show you all the parameters and functionalities in here. So we will click on tuning. Over here at the top, you have Kawasaki riding management and general. In general, you have the engine shift lamp, the call notification, email notification, units, date and clock sync, riding log settings. Coming to the Kawasaki riding management, from here, you can see the Ninja 1000 SX model selected over here. And you can change all these parameters. Over here, you can see riding mode where you can select sport. You can turn on the quick shifter and you have to send the settings to your motorcycle. So once you send the settings, you get a notification on the motorcycle screen and you have to select apply and apply the settings. So once you apply, now you can see over here the bike is set to the sport mode. You just have to click OK. The quick shifter is on, the quick shifter icon is displayed over here. and the sport mode is displayed over here.
So the best part about this functionality is you can set these parameters sitting at your home, and once you connect the motorcycle, automatically you can send these settings and apply it, and your settings are applied to the motorcycle.